Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory with the second part to the pitting and basically weathering of chrome parts. As you can see here, I have them mounted and it's going to be very simple. I normally do this outside, but I wanted to have a little bit more control over the video here, and you know, my video assistant is not around today, so we are going to be flying solo here. Now, normally I start off with dull coat, as I mentioned before. This one is sort of, I think it's going on empty. Let me just squirt. Yeah, actually it's going to be just fine. It's spitting, which is something that I don't really recommend. So I think we are going to go with the Lusterless Flat, okay, which is another, you know, product that that works. And I've set up the camera. We are about, I would say, 24 inches or so from where we are going to be going. And obviously, you know, if you're doing this, remember, wear your mask, wear your protective gear. I'm just doing this one time again for the video. And besides, it's just a little bit of a spurt. But even so, you know, protect yourself if you're doing this to a lot of parts. So, you know, we are practicing our burst. And you can see it here, my finger. And, you know, just a little like that. Just a little burst like that. And we are holding the parts, you know, from this distance. So, you know, kind of aim on it and then walk the part towards the, you know, walk the parts towards the burst, and you begin to see it, how it's it starts to get to look a little bit sprayed and pitted. Okay, now I also like to put a little bit of, you know, a primer spatter, both the gray or the ruddy brown or the black. You know, you could do a variety, and the same thing works. You know, test your burst. There you go. Now this one is more powerful, so you're gonna want to hold your part way back there and then walk it. So you see it back here, and so I'm holding the spray right where the camera viewer is, you know, so we're looking at maybe 28, almost 30 inches. Okay, let the burst go and walk the part towards it like that. Okay, and it's going to pick up just enough. Now remember, the rule is to do it a little at a time. You can go adding. Okay, remember, it's easier to add than it is to sort of burst apart and mangle it. You know, I mean, you could practice on the back of what's not going to be seen. So you could do some of that, you know, like that, and it'll pick up, but it's going to be too much. You want to burst, you know, and then sort of burst and walk the part towards the burst, and it'll pick up enough. The same thing with the ruddy primer, and it's just so that it picks up a little bit of variety, you know. And again, you go like that, and you walk the part towards it, and you can begin to see how it picks it up. And so you do enough of it until you sort of feel like, okay, you know what, I like where it's at. Or you could repeat the process several times until you begin to get the effect you're after. Okay, it's that simple. And you know, there is no there's no order to this. It's just sort of making sure that you get enough of it on there to start pitting and kind of misting the part so that it picks it up. That actually picked up enough you know, so that it's perfect. Again, I just like to build up the effect. I don't like to I don't like to flood the whole thing because then it changes the color too fast. That's plenty right there for the ruddy. Okay, and then I'm gonna switch to the gray. And again, just, you know, just a little bit of a burst. You get, you know, and you can also go like that and turn the part as you're bursting it. And it, again, walk it so that it sort of sticks on there. And you'll see it. You begin to see how it begins to dull on you. And it you know, once you see it in pictures, it looks, you know, like it's pitting and it's realistic enough. Then if you want to, you know, do the ultra flat just to get a little bit of it on there to start dulling the, that worked perfect. So it's that simple, my friends, you know, and after it dries, then you can apply washes and things like that. So that's what I'm going to do to this next. But anyway, this technique is that simple and is that much fun. And your, and you know, you can do it with rattle cans. You can do it with the airbrush. I just like rattle cans because, you know, why go through the trouble when you get just as good of an effect on there. And I hope you can see it, you know. It's just dull enough now so that it looks weathered. You know, and it's just upon close inspection, once we add the a little bit of a wash, it'll just be perfect. Anyway, let me know what you think. And again, a real treat watching, you know, showing you how we do this here in the laboratory. And it does give it, when you're working on rusty vehicles, it does make a big deal of difference. You could practice, again, on the surfaces that are not going to be seen. Normally, after I glue the, you know, I remove some of the chrome so that the parts will, in fact, glue well to the bumper braces. And then I come in with the airbrush and I will just sort of darken the backs of the chrome. That way it's, you know, it's sort of faded and certainly more weathered. All right. All right, my friends, Dr. Cranky here. I hope you enjoyed this clinic, and there'll be more. So stay tuned in for more. All righty. Bye-bye.